Anyway, let's get into it. What's good, everybody? Welcome to Magic Pixel episode 35. Woo! Damn.
What the fuck? It's Tuesday already?
Tuesday.
Why am I so hurt?
Tuesday, innit?
Comes by so quick, doesn't it?
How many episodes till we pass the chain?
We're already in the shit on air, huh? Let me look it up.
We're close, right? Like
we are pretty close for
10
sure.
More, 20 more. We're getting.
I got a real question for you guys. Also, considering what's about to happen, you guys have already made your second characters, or
I have rolled my stats, and I know what I'm going to play for my second character.
I haven't done anything, but I mean, I have a concept. Sure.
Yeah, I have a concept as well, but I haven't done any of like actual shit.
The worst part about dying, I think, in our campaign is our artist is busy. Like she is. You know, she got work, so we're gonna have to find someone else to do character art.
Let's just draw our own.
Yeah.
Everyone's bearing art.
I would love that. Yeah. I would love to see
that Wingstop sponsorship.
Sajam's next character is gonna be Tommy Tenderloin. It's gonna be Jam Jimadome.
dude, we've been past them, dude.
Oh man, really? That's pretty great.
Yeah.
Yeah, 27 episodes.
Damn, we're beast.
Damn.
Where's our $1 million?
We've had $1 million Kickstarter.
Yeah, Honzo, aren't you you're a biz dev? How's that going?
I'll write a campaign book.
Oh yeah, no.
You'll write the campaign book.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll include like crystal dragons that are different crystals, and then we'll get a.
Instead of jet dragons.
Guards?
Cease and desist.
We got a plan now.
Cease and desist. No, these are.
Can you include a dragon wings recipe in there for our collaboration with Wingstomp?
Nice.
Easy.
Ooh, they're
spicy.
Dude,
that's actually a great idea. Imagine these campaign books, like recipes, you know, it's from Wingstomp. And it's
literally just lemon pepper.
They released the cookbook. They could have done it.
We have to make them out of turkey wings so they're bigger.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Lemon pepper fucking turkey leg.
That sounds great.
Dragon wings.
Insane.
Dragon wings, yeah. It's the mix. It's the garlic parm, lemon pepper mix.
I still got to go and request that shit. I just do
Don't
it.
Do it for me at my Wingstop.
Your Wingstop is, they're wizards.
Yeah. how much you paid them off? Are you slipping them something under the table for that? What the fuck, man?
I've actually been getting discounts lately. I got 12 wings for $10.
This is fucked.
What?
The last time we ordered wings, we ordered 20 wings. They gave us 10 wings, two drinks, and some celery or something. I was like, bro, what the fuck happened? The wrong flavors. I was like, this is bullshit.
The wings are cold as fuck, too.
Yeah, dude. they didn't even cook them. You just see there's like frost on them. I'm like, what the fuck happened?
It's like salmonella.
Speaking of, Tanman, how did your poke order go?
Oh, there's a lot of wasabi. That's about all.
I was talking about the fact that you didn't pick a base. Yeah, and like he was like, my order's wrong. And then he goes, oh, maybe I just didn't pick a base.
Well, that doesn't make sense because usually they require a base. So I'm like, how would I not pick a base? I don't understand this.
I went back and looked, and it's like on my order, it's like white rice. And then on your order, there's nothing. It's not there at all.
It's best pure meal out there.
Yeah.
Don't need no extra carbs.
True, I guess.
He's cutting, bro.
Just eating wasabi.
Yeah. His bowl was like half wasabi, half fish.
It fell into the bowl, so I was like, oh, God damn it. How do I get this out?
It sounds delicious. Just wasabi and fish.
Well, let's all fall into a bowl, some Dungeons and Dragons as we get into Magic Pixel episode 35. Last time on our adventures in Dungeons and Dragons, everybody in the party had infiltrated the City of Stars, which is now kind of occupied predominantly by the Cult of Cronus, having recruited some giant allies from the nearby mountains, as well as made some allies with Celestials, fallen or otherwise, demons as well at the held, have seemed to be taking a stronghold in the city. But there are a couple of pockets of resistance as well that the party has learned about, one of which being the Order, another of which being the Changeling stronghold, formerly Variety, down in the Undercity of the City of Stars itself, which is also holding captive two of the Wind Dukes that the players had made a deal with in exchange for some gold to retrieve some information about a lost artifact or a lost part of an artifact which they had accomplished and now looking for a return. Once they made their way there, they were able to talk to Casimir. One of the changelings are who they believe to be Casimir that was in charge of the stronghold itself. After being able to do away with a lot of Maw demons, these weird demonic creatures that have been infesting the stronghold itself, starting to eat a lot of the changelings and just in general wreak havoc. They were able to put them away and find out that Casimir was actually being impersonated by a Cambion who was encouraging them to go to the Gladiator District, infiltrate the Colosseum, and do some things there. But they eventually found the real Casimir and started to take a short rest before. I can't remember if you guys actually talked to the Wind Duke or not. I don't think you actually did, right?
You
persuaded them to let them go. That's correct. Okay. Yeah. So you guys have persuaded the changelings to let the Wind Dukes go. And while taking a short rest here, you found out that one of the big creatures on the outside that you saw coming into Variety, a big demonic ape, had crushed its way through the building itself, and some of these like corpses of the changelings on the outside are starting to shamble in and fight their former compatriots. And that's where we lift off. So what do you all want to do as the infiltration begins?
So paint the picture for me. This ape just busted in and is just murdering people, or...
Yeah, so basically there's this picture that you're seeing right here. There's been a lot of shaking of the foundation of the building throughout this whole stay that you've been here, right? Which has only been about like 15 or so minutes, right? With the questioning you've done and the talking with Casimir or the Cambion and the fighting you've done and all that, and your like 10 minutes of rest that you got. It's only been like 15, 20 minutes so far that you're in here, but there's been constant just shaking from this giant demonic ape on the outside that's been hammering the foundation. And eventually, yeah, he just, as one of the weak points, just works on it enough to where he plows through the building. A lot of the building goes and just shatters across the room. One of the changelings gets thrown across the room and he grabs another and like brings it out. And you can just hear like the screams of the changeling as it gets crushed by this ape. And then you can see shambling in are these like broken, like you can see these changelings that were on the outside defending the outside of the stronghold itself at first with these broken bones and just gnarled like bodies starting to shamble in and attack the changelings itself too.
I'm casting motivational speech right now.
Right now. All right. All right. So you guys, we'll wait a minute.
What's your speech?
Laddies, formation. You may have seen the Crimson Ape, but let it not instill fear into your hearts. It's looking to raise some hell. We'll give it some hell and a couple bananas to boot. It won't be able to swallow. Men, arm thyselves. Prepare for battle. You like that?
That was pretty good. Yeah, that was great. I feel motivated.
I'd rage.
I'm running from the bottom of the place to the top.
I'm motivated.
You all get 5 temporary HP, by the way.
I need it.
You guys definitely get some buffs.
Okay. Do I catch the end of this motivational speech?
Hey, what's up?
Yeah,
bananas.
All right, I walk in and I hear men. I'm like, yeah. I'm like, hell yeah. All right, 5 temp HP, right? Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
To pull a card or not to pull a card?
Let you guys know, you guys have advantage on wisdom saving throws. If you get hit by an attack, you get advantage on the next attack roll.
Ooh. All right, I run in, and the state of things here, what's the sit rep?
What's the sit rep? You're running up to the top side where the action's happening?
Yes.
Yeah, I screamed down when the fucking ape busted through.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, so you can see as you guys all begin to come into this area. What's up?
I have a stupid question.
What's up?
Do I know what fiends are afraid of? I don't even think I know as
I mean, in what sense of the word? Just like a common weakness, like are
something
you talking about
that would ward them from a space?
Ward them from a space. Give salt. Me a religion check.
Salt in a circle, is that what this is?
Yeah, like I don't know. Oh, horrible. 12
dance.
12 on a religion check, you know that there's certain spells that could keep the demonic or undead out, like, you know, hollowing an area or something like that. If you have access to those, you know, capabilities, you could perhaps like ward them away, but something that would like signify like a stake to a vampire or something like that, you don't really know.
Can I give Minoscus 10 points of lay on hands?
Sure.
All right, I'll drop you 10 HP.
So as you like kind of heal Minoscus a little bit, as you start rushing up the stairs towards this area, yeah, you can see now, having taken a minute to gather yourselves and prepare for this battle, a lot of the changelings here are severely injured, and there are seems to be more corpses kind of making their way in. There doesn't seem to be any more of these, like, none are rising. There's no active, like, zombies being created or something like that. But there's still a few, mainly from the outside of what the changelings were trying to hold down that perished, were actually coming in now. And the ape itself is wounded, you can see, but definitely has plenty of fight left in him. And I think as you guys all come up the stairs and see this, I need everybody to roll initiative.
Alrighty.
For the surroundings, is there, remember how we fought the turrets? Is there any turrets around that people can man or are manning?
No, not
from inside.
Damn it.
Ooh.
Pretty banal.
Changing.
14.
Shebenthi.
I have an idea, but.
17, you said?
Changeling stronghold. Nice. 17,
no.
Indeed.
No, that's annoying.
That's like from the outside, yeah. So they're on the inside now.
Gotcha.
I was gonna blast him with what's his name? Dala Brakka, but I was too inspired.
Yeah, this fucking battle music is hype, dude.
The end game. Doom doom music. Doom 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 doom. The end game. Last battle.
And then what's Soren's?
17. I updated it.
You already did it? Okay. Okay. So, and then let me give the change. Let me get that.
We're in the end game now.
Minus nails?
Shit, those go pretty hard, actually, like that. All right. So at the top of the order, I believe Dala Brakka, I think, has higher dex than Thorn. But I mean, you guys can throw that at yourself. Both of you have 17, so.
Do you want to go first?
Thorn has higher dex, doesn't he? My
dex is 14.
I can go first. That's cool.
Yeah. You can blast.
Yeah.
These NPC changelings are our allies?
Yes.
Okay, so the enemies
These are the corpses.
Okay, so two corpses and the gorilla. These three. Okay.
Okay, so I'm gonna cast Vicious Mockery on the big ol' ape.
Okay.
Oh, I've got a big banana for you, monkey boy. I'm starting things off.
And this is a wisdom saving throw?
It is.
13.
13? Oh, he gets hit big time, dude.
Oh, wait.
Oh, don't lie to me.
Yes. All right.
Okay. He gets hit for 5 damage.
Nice.
And then let me see this order real quick. Okay. I'm going to cast Bardic Inspiration on the man at top.
Okay.
It's time to show him what you lizards are really made of.
I'm fucking bleeding out of my eyeballs. Okay.
He's pretty fucked up.
Anything else?
That's my turn.
Sore.
Okay. I'm going to book it straight up the stairs past him. Ben! As he does his speech. And I'll book it right here to the first changeling. And I will hack at him.
Okay.
These things are like all cracked and broken and shit.
Yeah, they basically are. They were in a fight with a demon gorilla before, and he killed them. So imagine the injuries that one would sustain doing that.
All right, I'm gonna hack the limbs off like the Black Knight, so they can't attack anymore. First attack is 17 to hit.
17, it does hit.
And I will swing it. For 9 slashing.
Okay.
Second attack. Ooh. 13 to hit.
13 misses.
Yeah, and then for my... I'll just swing again, actually, for my bonus action. 21 to hit.
21 hits?
And I'll smite. Are these fiends or undead?
They are fiends, yes.
So I get an extra D8? Okay. So it's 10 slashing.
10 slashing.
And then, oh my sweet Jesus. 16 radiant.
And 16 radiant, very nice, okay.
And that'll be my turn.
All right.
Fucking tight, by the way. This shit is getting sicker by the minute.
So as you slash into this corpse, injuring it further than it already has, it kind of looks at you and then it twists its head around and just vomits blood like all on your nice, very nice armor. I need you to make a wisdom saving throw for me.
You have advantage. Advantage.
Okay. That's pretty good. Advantage will help. 21.
21. Okay, so you save as a very, very freaky moment, but not enough to kind of mess with your resolve or anything like that. It's going to try to attack you now. For 16 to hit. I'll be 16.
Misses, yeah.
Okay. So that is that one's turn. This one is going to come over to one of the changelings here.
No.
He's going to try to
Greg.
Attack you.
Watch Get out, Greg.
Ass, rolls a 23 on this guy.
Greg, no.
Fucking ripped.
Oh my god.
Oh, Jesus.
So you see, as this corpse kind of comes up, it like holds out his hand, and coming like from the hand, you see this spectral tendril just come, and it's like there's a black inky tendril that comes out of the hand of the corpse itself and just like wraps around the throat of the changeling and just squeezes until it has no more life left.
Greg.
That's graphic.
He just one shot that guy.
Yeah.
No, okay. Greg.
Did he get 5 temp HP? Is that...
was,
rotten, right?
Was 5 other creatures. Was Greg the creature you picked?
Right? No, it says anybody who hears it, dude. That's what it says.
Didn't we run up here, though?
I don't know. I ran up.
Greg's dead.
Well, yeah, Greg is dead. Way. We have to move on. Minoscus is your
turn. I'm
on Rynge. God, I keep getting the same fucking things.
Wait. Where's
Bobadan? Where is Bobadan indeed? Let me see. Hold on.
Spiritual.
What's your passive perception?
My passive perception is 13.
You do not know where Bobadan is?
Son of a bitch!
You gave that great battle speech and he slipped behind the bar.
He's still invisible.
Yeah.
Oh, this is the old wild search. I need to get the other table true. Again.
Oh, you can just update your character to the new one.
Well, no, this is updated for some reason, so it's off. Because this is the one that gave me a bunch of temp HP.
Oh.
So, let me...
Dude.
I need to try to fix this.
You're going to kill me?
I will.
He's done it before. He's killed Rodan, so...
Yeah.
No one was mad at him. They were all mad at me.
Each creature of your choice that you could see within 30 feet must succeed on a constitution saving throw or take 1d12 necrotic and also gain temp HP equal to 1d12 plus your barbarian level. That's actually nice. I need that. So I guess only one because
it's only hit anyone else. Or I mean, you can run and then activate it.
Yeah,
let's try that. Let's see. 5,
I have hella movement.
10, 15, 20. 25, 30, 35. I need to be here to attack 40. The range. Oh, nice. They are.
Yeah. So all three of them, right?
Yeah.
Can you
and what is the constitution saving throws?
Yes.
Okay.
Can you zoom in on these changelings' face? I want to see their hair.
See, I was trying to earlier. It wasn't working. Oh, there we go.
Oh, damn. Look at these guys' hair. When did they fucking get all fancy?
Yeah, nice style.
Wow. Looks good.
And it's constitution?
Yeah.
That's just all coming from the side of his head, right? I can do that.
Constitution,
okay.
That's what I got going on right now.
Yeah, dude. We can do that shit, right?
Easy. That old Asmongold.
We're bald by choice.
Okay, so the two changeling corpse zombie things succeed, but the ape does not.
All right, they take two damage, or it takes two damage.
Okay.
And then I get 1d12 plus my barb level.
Ooh.
So I get a total of 12 temp HP. So
damn, 17. That's pretty good.
It doesn't stack with your other temp HP.
It does not, so it just overwrites.
It's just 12.
Yeah.
Just 12 of it.
All right. Anything else?
I'll start hacking at this guy down here.
Yeah.
No, Greg!
Greg!
He's the only one whose name we knew.
That's the only one. You hear one of the changelings, his name is Lee, goddammit!
17 to hit.
17 hits.
Alright. That is 18 damage.
18 damage, okay.
And that is all for now.
Wait, don't you have two attacks?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So you were so distraught about Greg, you forgot about your second attack.
22.
A hit.
A hit, and then 12 damage.
12 damage, very nice, okay. You hack into him. It definitely looks like you take a lot out of this like a possessed corpse of the changeling as we go into a talk.
Okay. I'm going to take out a pillow that I have, and I'm going to cut into it a little bit and take out a little bit of fleece. And remembering what I read in the book, I'm going to cast Silent Image with the fleece. I'm going to put it in my mouth and attempt to blow in it because I can't whistle because I have no lips. Let's go. And then I'm going to cast Silent Image right here. Oh, can I ping? Hold on. Right here.
Okay.
It's a 15-foot cube. And what I'm going to make is an exact copy of this gorilla, but what I'd imagine a female version to look like.
Okay.
As, and then on their forehead, like a tattoo, it's just going to say, I miss you in common.
Okay. In common, talk. You said?
Yeah, in abyssal.
Okay, in abyssal.
Yeah, and then it's gonna look a little like a ghost. Kind of like a little bit like a wraith, you know?
Okay.
A shade.
You just assume that this ape has a long lost female lover that's perished?
Yes, it's called a Hail Mary.
And I'm gonna has fleece.
I'm going to fleece pillows. I have one actually. And I want to put female demon special girl. And I'm gonna put it between the gorilla and Soren. Okay. So it's like it takes up the path.
Sure.
And then I don't. Correct. Yeah, and I don't know sign language, so I can't have it be like love. okay. I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to book it. I'm outy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'll be over here.
Okay.
And I'll just yell at... I'll yell at Sonny, get back.
Okay. It's the other thing's turn now. Oh, no, I just made them both go on that turn. That's fine. We'll just keep it at that. Sonny will retreat. Alexander.
All right. 10 years later. All right. What are we doing here? We're fucking moving. Get out of here. I'm at this point. I'm going to take a shot at the one Minoscus is battling.
Okay.
We'll use... we'll use the bow.
Your Tarok bow.
21
hits
for 21.
Oh, 21. Shit.
21.
All right. Yeah, as you slice through with this bow, it takes a huge, just like it gets it right in the back of the neck. And you can see it kind of seize up and almost like paralyzed. Basically, it looks very injured at this point.
And I will continue my trek on behind Sunny. Well, actually, no, we'll go over here. and we'll take cover behind one of the tables that's laying around.
Okay.
Because that's all there is. Tables in this room. 12. Woo!
All right. Nice.
That's 21 backwards.
You tip a table over, breaks.
I jumped over the table and fucking like ducked down, and the table just kept rolling on its side. I was like,
it just kept going.
This changeling tries to come up and using like some flinging tactics, tries to take advantage of a meniscus, but just whiffs on the opponent that you're facing. Elixir will come over and try to do something about it, though. Let's see here. He's going to swing here. For a hit.
That's a bajillion.
Yeah, and you can see as he slices this changeling corpse has kind of been possessed. After that, it seems like it takes the vitality that was left out of the body, pretty much depletes it. But what floats from the body itself is kind of those spectral, like jellyfish-looking things that you saw on the outside, kind of hovering around the ape on the outside. And it seems to be like hovering over, kind of still in a hostile manner, over this body. And he is going to try to swing at that. For just barely hits.
Damn.
Jesus.
Yeah.
So much damage.
Yeah. Yeah, and you can see it kind of like reels back, and he, having a magical sword, kind of does connect fully with this like weird jellyfish spectral entity. And now it is the ape's turn, and he sees a female demon seduction gorilla in front of him. He's got to make an intelligence saving throw.
He has no style. He has no grace.
This Kong is a funny face.
What's your DC?
So my DC for intelligence is higher than my other spells, so it's 14.
14, okay. He rolled terribly. Wait. It's an intelligence saving throw, though, right?
It's, hold on. Let me look at it. It's an investigation check.
It's an investigation check?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Okay. And what's the DC?
It's 14.
14? Okay. He fails. So you can see this demon who has been rampaging mostly, and you can only see like on his face pure like want and need for destruction, all of a sudden just like kind of pauses at the sight of this demon spectral gorilla, and every type of anger just seems to drain from him. His muscles kind of sag a little bit, and everything just that was what he wanted before just kind of leaves his mind for a second, and he kind of goes at the spectral demon gorilla and tries to hug it, and then it just vanishes in his arms, and he looks even more angry than he did before. But that is his turn.
This Kong has a funny face.
This is a legendary action now.
Dollar Brock, it's your turn.
Let me see here. So with my newly powered up mic, I can only use like one of the spells for the second level spells like only once.
Yeah. So choose between the three. What happened?
I can only choose between the three, right? Not each spell once, right?
No, each spell once.
Oh hell yeah, dude.
Yeah, each spell once.
Ooh, baby, it's a trample. I'm backing up a little bit.
What are you doing?
I gotta also check before I start my turn. Hey, Wodan! I call out for Wodan.
Okay, you call out for Wodan. Give me a persuasion check.
It is a 24.
24, okay. So you call out for him, and about like a good like 40 feet, kind of like where you guys are at the stairs, kind of like still kind of hanging around there, you hear a voice respond. Yeah, what do you want?
Oh, check this shit out. I'm gonna fucking, well, I just wanted to use it to gauge where he was at.
Okay.
Pass lightning bolt.
Light punch.
Use.
Lightning bolt on this gorilla.
Yeah, straight line. Actually, no. Let me move up a little bit more. I move like 10 feet. I'm gonna move. Okay.
Nice.
And I'm gonna lightning bolt straight through, shot through the heart. And you want to you give apes a bad name.
Perfect. Okay, and that's a dexterity saving throw.
Yes, 16.
Okay, so the ape succeeds in his rampage. Let me see if this other guy succeeds. Ooh, okay, so they both succeed.
Damn.
Okay.
What they have damage.
Let's see. 7, 15 total, and then. Oh, wait. Last two, sorry.
Is Lightning Bolt 8d6?
Yeah.
So hell yeah.
8d6? Or.
27, half of 27 rounded down or rounded up?
Yeah, rounded down. So 13?
Yeah.
Okay. Gotcha. Gotcha.
As the lightning bolt flies by me, I like try to lean into it and I can't reach it because this thing's in the way.
And, don't try to grab it, fella.
And as you try to kind of lean into it, Soren, and it doesn't hit you, but does clip these two demons ahead of you, you can see that not only did they manage to get out of the way of most of the lightning, but the lightning that did hit them actually does what you are trying to desire your armor to do and it kind of resists the lightning damage that they do take.
Damn.
But yeah, it is your turn now, Soren, unless you want to do like a bonus action or something else.
Let me also cast Healing Word.
Can't spell.
What is this shit?
Bardic Inspiration?
Yeah, that's what I wanted to do. I'm an idiot. I'm going to cast it on Soren as well.
Nice. All right, Soren is
your turn. Word is literally right above Bardic Inspiration. I read the wrong one.
Yeah, you do both a lot. They're right there next to each other.
Motherfucker.
All right. I will. This thing has not had its ghost thingamajig pop out of it yet. The thing in front of me.
No.
Okay. The one at the
bottom
has. Yeah, I'm in the bottom.
All right. Well, I'm gonna swing at the one above me then. I'll put this on. For a 15 to hit.
15 hits.
Okay. Oh my god. 8 slashing damage.
Okay. Still up, but it's looking like the corpse is on its last legs.
Okay. Yeah, I'll swing again. 14 to hit.
It just barely hits.
Alrighty. For another 13 slashing.
Okay, so yeah, it depletes the corpse and this kind of spectral like jellyfish entity kind of floats out of it.
All right, I'll just kick the corpse over and jump up and try to stab it. For a 25 to hit.
Hits.
For 9 slashing.
9 slashing, very nice. Wait, anything else?
I don't know if I want to move. Is this gorilla going to reach me?
Yes.
Oh yes, I'll stay.
Okay. It is the spectral jellyfish's turn. They're going to. We'll do your attack first, Thor. Ooh. 23.
Hits.
All right. You take 13 necrotic damage.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. You also.
They all have cost parasite.
Ooh, you also, your hit point maximum is reduced by 6.
Oh no.
I cannot get hit.
Yeah, okay. That's very
cool. And then this is the one on Minoscus. Minoscus, you didn't reckless, right?
No, I did not.
13 to hit?
That misses.
All right, nice. It is your turn.
All right, I'm going to go back at it. This thing seems a. Dangerous enough, so I'm gonna reckless it now. That's a 28 to hit.
Mm-hmm.
For 14 damage.
Nice.
And then double 16, so that's 25 to hit for 15 damage.
Nice. So with your second swipe, you kind of dissipate the jellyfish. It lets out this ghostly wail, and then it kind of just like zeros away, like in Marvel 3, just kind of dissipates. Yeah.
I can't do the noise.
It is gone.
Damn, I don't have many bonus actions. Let me see if I can do anything. No, I need to brush. All right, I'm going to just fucking step into this illusion. Ooh. I'll take the hits. This is not going to go well.
You don't know if it's fake or not.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Well, this is disgusting. And I'm like, whoa, what is going on here?
he's chaperoning the dance 6 feet apart, dude. Leave room for Jesus.
Wow. I go next to Sor. What's going on over there? It's kind of weird.
I don't know, bro. There's like two monkeys now, man. I don't know what's happening.
It was like on a bed or something, right? Or like some sort of.
No, it was just standing.
I didn't make like it's on a bed.
Trying to make it attractive or something.
What I imagine.
It's mad
inserted fantasies into this shit.
Wow. I thought that's what Honzo had. I was like, he probably made a sexy monkey or something.
It's probably like Donkey monkey. Kong.
Look, it's
sexy monkey over there.
All that matters sexy is that monkey. It's sexy to him.
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever I think sexy monkeys look like. So
just as the lizard man.
I'll just surround this jellyfish and end my turn.
Okay.
I'm gonna move. I can move my as an action. I'm gonna move the monkey, the sexy demon gorilla monkey, to like here-ish, like so it's behind everyone. But when I make it reappear, I'm gonna have it miss three fingers on their left hand, and I'm gonna make the gorilla hold up the hand with the missing three fingers and then point at me, Atoq. And as my bonus action, I'm gonna use my three mummified elf fingers that I have, and I'm gonna hold them up and just dangle them, and then I'm gonna run away.
What?
That's funny.
I'm booking it. I'm going. I'll dash this way.
Oh man!
Oh, I can't dash, but I'll end here.
All right, Sunny's gonna follow you.
Yeah.
I'm gonna get smoked. He's gonna land right next to me. He'd be pissed off.
He's got fucking teleport.
Wait until he plane shifts. This monkey plane shifts over. He's like, run.
With his legendary action, he fucking grapples you and then plane shifts.
That'd be tight.
All right, that was unexpected. I need to get the hell away from this guy.
It's away from me.
Oh my god.
I mean, I guess that's far enough. Am I hidden from the monkey?
Oh, what was it? 12?
12.
12, yeah.
You are not hidden from the monkey.
It was a natural one. So.
It was.
Oh, shit.
All right.
We'll get there eventually.
We'll bow him again. Or try to bow him. 16?
16, I think, hits. Yes, just barely.
Nobody's within 5 feet. Fucking GG's. 9 damage.
Okay. Hit the other thing. Sexy gorilla.
Is that bow magical?
Hell no.
No. My bow.
That's a bit of the damage from the arrow.
Didn't you lose
it's a good
that
thing
bow?
I didn't distract him from his mission.
No, it's my bow.
Oh, okay.
Shit, I'll hide again.
No.
The fucking Christ 13.
Hey, it's an improvement. Hey,
you are still not hidden from the monkey.
Stupid, smart ape.
The changeling. Oh, yeah, one's still alive here. Okay. It is. It like turns around to go like help with the other spectral jellyfish and just sees this female demon spectral gorilla in its way and just sitting there and there. It looks wrong.
You scared the wrong thing.
Takes two attacks at the fake spectral gorilla.
Yeah. Not another one.
I'm missing an attack at top of the
game. Yeah, honestly, let me see. He's got to make an investigation check here, dude. Let me see. Yeah. So I think one attack does get wasted from Elixir on this other demon gorilla as he fails his investigation check, swipes at it. Sees that it's an illusion, then goes to the big one.
When was there two monkeys? What?
But he rolled a natural 20, so you know.
Oh, no. I made up for it.
This thing's gonna explode. Elixir rolls like 900 dice every time he swings.
Yeah, he does. Let me see.
I don't know who he's attacking with.
He rolled 8d8 and rolled 48.
Yeah, I roll 4 8s and 1 7. So Elixir kind of goes up after seeing that the first ape is just an illusion. The second one, he just connects cleanly, and a huge burst of psychic energy just comes from the sword, more than you guys are used to seeing, and just like it decimates a huge chunk of this ape, just kind of like taking off a full chunk of his like a torso, just like completely missing, like there's a hole in the side of him. As he does it, get clipped with that. I need Minoscus, Elixtro, and Soren all to make Constitution saving throw.
You get plus four.
I get plus four? Okay.
Elixtro gets a two, right?
Yeah.
Damn right he does.
Man, that was not good for me.
I rolled a one, so I have 11.
Dude, Elixtro also failed because he rolled a fucking two.
13 for me.
Okay,
good
so
God.
I rolled a seven, but I have plus six.
Okay.
I can't believe I rolled a one. Okay. So you guys are all you can see this like disease like ichor come from the gorilla and just sprays all over you guys. I need
another roll? Oh no.
Everybody that took that loses 7 from their maximum hit points.
Oh no.
7?
Yeah, 7 hit points.
Seven.
And now is the Demon Ape's turn. He's going to get all up in everybody's business, and he's going to take his first attack at Elixir.
Try, guys.
Which is at disadvantage because of the one thing. The bardic thing. So he misses the Elixir. Next one will be at Soren. 25
hits.
I'm letting it rock. This is just a swing, right? Swing towards Soren?
Yeah.
Please, cutting words on that?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
You need a 5 or higher?
I hold up three fingers.
4 or 5?
4 where he would get his AC, so I think you need a 5.
Yeah, you need to roll a 5 or higher.
Oh, shit. 3?
Nope.
Okay. So, you try to distract this ape with some cutting words as that goes for Soren, but you can see the rage now in his eyes from the demon spectral gorilla being fake. It's just too much to really distract him at this point. He just swings. And Minoscus is going to be the last one at you.
Reckless.
You reckless attack, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, that should hit you with a 21.
Yep.
Right. Okay.
I think you guys both get advantage during the next
one.
Yeah.
So Soren, you take 16 slashing damage.
Jesus.
Well.
And you, Minoscus, take 18 slashing damage, half to 9.
3 times.
Dala Brakka, it's your turn.
I said that as a character, as my character. What are you at, 11? Oh fuck, dude. No bueno. You're not looking too good over there, pal. I'm gonna go ahead and let me see this. Level 2 healing word on Soren.
Soren.
My leg.
Let's see, 3, 4. Alright, get ready, dude. I gotcha, bud. Oh, it's 1. Nine HP.
Nice.
Was he rolling his attack rolls like with disadvantage? The monkey? I wasn't.
The first one he did roll with disadvantage, yeah.
Well, he's gonna have to do it again. A vicious mockery.
Alright.
I changed voices. Let's see you try to swing again, you big banana bitch.
For a wisdom saving throw, he rolled a 16 this time.
Oh, it's yeah.
That's the DC.
Yeah, it should be DC 16.
Okay. So he again is into body field with rage. He acknowledges you and turns towards you and makes eye contact. And you think when he gets through with these guys, he's coming for you next.
Yeah, come bring it, bitch. I'm still on my high of my own speech, so.
Soren.
I crack my back as he fucking slammed the shit out of me, and I'm like, all right, that sucked, bros. And I'm gonna swing. How this thing above me looks pretty fragile, correct?
Yeah, it looks injured, but like the spectral form, it doesn't look that like bad.
All right, yeah, I'm swinging at this little thing first.
All right.
Advantage.
Oh yeah, I have advantage on this attack. Okay. Oh god, thank god I have advantage. 17 to hit.
That hits.
I'm gonna smite it.
What?
I will level 2 smite.
Alright, still qualifies as a demon, so.
Yeah, so it's 10 slashing. And then, okay. Oh boy, 11, 12, 18 radiant damage.
Okay, now it looks significantly hurt. It's still floating there, not completely dissipated yet, but a lot of it is kind of like flickering in and out of existence.
Second attack is 18 to hit.
Hits.
For 13 slashing.
13, all right, now it looks barely still in this plane, but it still is.
40 damage and it's still alive. Jesus. Oh, bonus action attack. 24 to hit.
That hits.
For 8 slashing.
Okay, yeah, I had 5 more health.
Okay. I spin it around and it just freaking cut through it. And then I'm like, yep, no problem, Broham. And I'll turn towards the big monkey.
Okay, and that is the remainder of those jellyfish. So, Minoscus, it's your turn.
Easy peasy.
All right, so this raging monkey, I'm raging. Do I resonate with it?
Oh, yeah. 100% you resonate with this monkey, dude. And considering the blind rage that you also feel all the time, especially with your wild surge style where it's just kind of going through you in this wild magic, you can feel the magic kind of radiating off this demon gorilla very much, very much so.
Hell yeah.
All right. He yells at me, and I yell back, and 22
hits.
I'm going to fucking die.
For 19 damage.
Okay.
And then 19 to hit.
19 hits.
For another 19 damage.
And how do you want to finish off the gorilla?
Yeah! And I just take a jumping slash right at its neck. And then I throw it at the female sexy monkey thing. To realize it's an illusion because it goes right through.
Yeah, as you slice it, though, I need you all to once again make constitution saving throws.
Maybe this wasn't a good idea.
Oh, no.
Do we still get the
that's
plus four?
That's just those
plus
three,
four,
right?
Yeah,
the ones nearest to the gorilla?
Yeah, just those three, yeah.
Elixir can make it with plus four.
Okay.
14.
16, and I'll spend my bardic inspiration, I guess. So 21.
Okay, so you said 14, Minoscus?
Yeah.
Okay, so you fail.
Someone quickly give me guidance.
That was with plus four? How bad did you roll?
I rolled 4.
Oh, Jesus. Okay.
Guys, doesn't work on saving throws.
And I also rolled 2d4. I rolled an 8 on 2d4, so decrease your maximum hit point by 8.
God damn it.
Ooh,
Jesus. I have this bolstering magic that would help, but I can't use it as like a reaction or anything.
Mm-hmm.
But as you did that and slice of the demon's gorilla and put it into him, you do take that last bit of ichor on you. You see Elixir and Soren kind of manage to dodge it, but you feel the poison kind of seep into your skin a little bit more, but that is kind of offset by the fact that you seem to have quelled the most immediate threat and you guys are out of initiative.
Okay. Let's fucking go.
Can
these
I...
things are fiends?
They are fiends.
All right, here's what I want to do. I want to ask all the changeling people to help me with this, and I'm going to take the gorilla body and whatever other tables and chairs and other shit and just barricade the front.
Okay, like the kind of holes that have opened up from the attacks and whatnot?
Yeah, him breaking down this fucking wall, I'm just going to start barricading it.
Okay, so you and the changelings that are healthy enough to work because, I mean, you guys did take a little while to get the motivational speech going and kind of prepare yourselves alone. So there are a hefty amount of changelings that are injured, and you can see some of them are kind of taking the ones that are more injured off to some type of like medical ward, you presume, or something like that. But you do have a handful of changelings that are willing to and know how important it is to shore up any holes in the defense at the moment that help you kind of close up the area.
Before they do that, I'm going to change the image to that gorilla and the female gorilla now. And they're together. And they just sit there holding hands, and then they wave at everyone, and then they die.
How do they die, though?
Their throats just open up, and all their blood comes out. And
normal death.
And then the spirits disappear.
They don't make out with the slits on their neck? Is that what you're going to make?
No.
Okay, you fucking puss.
Demon gorilla death.
Demon gorillas die peacefully.
Giant. Yeah, it's just playing like on a loop to your spell ends.
Oh yeah,
I'm like, I imagine I'm like barricading this fucking place, and this morbid thing is happening behind me. I'm like, ugh.
Nasty.
Perfect. So yeah, you can see the changelings are predominantly kind of preoccupied with either getting help to the ones that are injured or helping in whatever endeavors you guys kind of put them with. You see Soren, and they immediately start helping him. Casimir is trying to pretty much get everything as under control as he possibly can, trying to help both sides basically with whoever needs injured. If anybody needs help trying to barricade this stuff or any help in this immediate vicinity, what the rest of you want to do?
I want to contact Shava and just update her pretty much on what the new information I've learned, because I assume she knows nothing and she's still on her way.
Okay, so you go to contact Shava through your sending stone, and you get no response.
Curse.
Don't worry, bud. Maybe it's bad reception.
Yeah, bro. Phone lines are all tied up. You know how it is. Everybody's emergency contact and their loved ones.
She's dead.
Hey, that's not nice. She's my mom too, you know. What if I said the son was dead, huh?
It may be.
I look up at the hole. Oh, never mind.
Damn.
I give him one of these.
Cold blooded. What's it called? How good of a job is this patchwork barricade looking like?
Give me a survival check with advantage.
Okay. 14.
14? All right, so yeah, I mean, you guys have plugged the holes pretty well. Again, the demon body itself kind of is able to plug up the hole that it made and kind of insert into. You figure you kind of pile up some more debris and bodies behind it and give it some more fortification. And you do that for the various small entrances as well, where the mod demons or the different corpses from the changelings outside kind of came in through, and feel pretty decently confident. I mean, it's going to hold for a little while. I mean, it really depends on how big the threat that comes next, how effective it will hold.
I was going to say, we didn't see anything else that looked dangerous in this area. It's just literally this gorilla and these spirits.
Yeah, yeah. From the way you made it through the sewers and on your way here, that's all you really saw. You didn't see much anything else. It was kind of deserted. You kind of got the feeling of desertion for the most part, besides this activity.
Okay. All right. Then I'll tell them that they should look around and scavenge shit from other places. Okay. If there's nobody else around, just steal whatever fucking shit you need to plug this place up.
Yeah, I feel you. Okay, so you kind of talk and confer with Casimir a little bit about that, and he picks out some of the more equipped and qualified people to do so, and you guys kind of sent a squadron of 3 or 4 out into the Undercity itself to gather whatever supplies they could find. All right.
Hey, so, fortifying this place is all fine and dandy, but you gotta start thinking ahead. You gotta get out of here. This is no place to stay. And not for any period of time.
Isn't there also a couple enemies on the first floor of this place as well still? Or no?
No, this is the first floor. Where you guys are at. You took care of everything.
Oh, cool. I thought we were still on the third floor or something. All right, cool.
No, you guys are good. Yeah, and who are you saying this to, Alexander? Casimir? I would agree with you, but I'm not really sure where to go at this point. I think we could probably try to make our way to the devotion district and give their resistances another battalion to work with or something like that.
If you were to ask me, staying in the city at all is not something you should do if you and your people want to survive.
Give me a persuasion check.
Damn, persuading shit. Let's go fight to the death.
20.
So he kind of ponders for a moment and he looks up at you and he goes, "You think it's really that far gone?"
I mean, right before we came in here, I saw a bunch of giants destroying and just frolicking in the middle of the city. And then, like, as we walked in, I saw a demon that looked like a goat throw a giant bolt of lightning out of the sky and destroyed an entire building.
Yeah. I was going to say, yeah, I got to find that thing and maybe take a hit or two so that I could, you know, really test this armor out. Seems like it shouldn't be a problem.
And you see, he's kind of shook at your comments, and then Soren kind of says what he says, and he looks very peculiarly at Soren, like, how is he so nonchalant about the situation? And he goes, "You all seem much more well-equipped to deal with this than any of us."
The hell perhaps we do.
I just, like, look at him, and I'm like, "Look, I think if you want to get out of the city, you probably should. If you need a safe place to, like, go and then find a path out, if, like, you're in trouble, the Devotion District probably makes sense. It seems like it's probably the safest place. We haven't been there yet, but that's where we're going next."
I'm going to walk up to Dala Brakka as I'm, like, picking glass out of my wounds and just say, "Talk to your people."
Dala?
Fishes?
I'm thinking, but... Okay. I would say, you know... y'all need to get the hell out of here, too, but... I'm still... Whoa, Dan!
And he kind of, like, stumbles out from the same place where you kind of heard him from last time, still invisible. He goes, "Yeah, yeah." Dala? Yeah?
I'm kind of at a loss here. I mean, like, I feel for these fellas, but at the same time, I don't even know what these guys should do.
Oh, you're consulting. I
get the hell out of here, fam.
I mean, that's all I got.
I don't really know where they would go, but it's far away from here.
Wodan counsels cowardice. Unexpected.
Hey, I mean, that to was be a joke. Fair...
I just look around. I'm like, "All right, before we do anything anyway, I need a rest." And I just, like, plop down.
Okay, so you guys want to take a short rest here?
Yeah.
I'm going to sit in a cell.
I'm triaging myself.
I will summon a giant lightning bolt to strike myself and regain a spell slot.
Okay.
With my channel divinity.
What's that? Just casually.
Yeah, just like an entire wave of electricity. And I'm just like, "Cool, bro. That was great."
All right, and then do the rest of you want to do anything specific during the short rest? I assume everybody's using hit die, so you can, like, song of rest if you want and all that.
Yeah, I'm doing something.
Oh, does our temp HP change? That's an important thing to know during this.
Yeah, so how long do it last? I think since it's a spell, it goes to long rest. But, like, anything that resets on a short rest would go away on a short rest.
Sorry, I meant max HP from the...
Oh.
Yeah, I didn't mean temp HP. That's my
bad. Oh, let me see here. No, it is not go back on a short rest.
Okay.
Yeah. You can give me a medicine or arcana check there, Soren.
Not good. 5.
Five. Okay. Yeah. I mean, you feel pretty sick.
Yeah. Okay. So I feel sick. Like a.
Yeah.
Can I spend 5 points of lay on hand to cure a disease or neutralize a poison affecting myself?
Oh yeah, you could definitely try.
I'll try it.
All right. So you spend the 5 points, and immediately that feeling of, like, sickness, and, you know, that ichor that got into your system just immediately gets purged by the divine power, and you feel back to normal. Your hit points go back up.
All right, I'll do it. Did it affect Elixir?
Yes, it affected everybody on the first time.
But not it affected Minoscus as well, right?
It did, yeah.
I look at both of them. I'm like, "All right, I can cure one of you." Who got hit by it worse?
Just give it to Elixir. And I go to my soul. I start trying to purge it out from my system. Jesus.
And Elixir goes, I mean, he got hit by it twice, man. It doesn't have to be me.
Yeah, I pat him on the back as he's vomiting, and I'll cure him.
Okay.
See, it worked. I feel much better.
Yep.
Yeah.
Elixir, he still looks a little pale.
Yeah, Elixir goes, I'm glad you feel better. The sight of throwing, oh, and just pukes to the side.
I go over and start inspecting their vomit.
All right, give me an investigation check.
Okay. Guidance. Mother, what is this? Really bad. 15.
15? Yeah, I mean, from what you could tell, mostly it's just made up of rations for the most
rats,
part.
Rats? Like a turn? He's eating his pets?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just rations?
Okay. It's rations.
All right, we're short resting.
Yeah, yeah. Does anybody else want to do anything specific?
No.
Alexander, Dala, Atoq, anything? Rustin.
Have nothing of import.
Sweet wraps, dude.
Okay. So, as everybody takes a short rest, how about we take our break here on Magic Pixel, and then we'll be.
What's the song of rest?
Song of rest.
Oh yeah, roll the song of rest.
It's give me a sec. Six. Four.
Okay.
Who else is using it?
Everybody.
Everyone is.
Everybody? Great.
The homie tools.
No, you just roll ones. Just roll.
Okay.
I'm at full.
Yeah, I'll make it there.
BRB bathroom break. Ha ha!
Yeah.
Ha ha.
I don't do drugs, unfortunately.
Welcome back to Magic Pixel, everybody. I hope it's going well.
That is the problem. That's why you're a bad roommate. You don't.
Yeah, I need to be the plug.
Do more drugs.
On that.
Yeah,
that's what fucking what's his name would tell you.
Pete the plug.
Steve.
No, the Seder.
The Seder Gloshtig.
Gloshtig.
My man Gloshtig. I'm sure he's handling this meltdown of the city well.
He's in fucking. He's in the Feywild.
He's in La La Land. Yeah.
Accidentally plane shift.
Dude, it's like when he touches the table and the dude.
That's how he casts the spell. He's just in another plane.
He has a gummy as his arcane component, and as he waits for it to kick in, and then he planes just randomly.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, that'd be interesting. Great character. The high level spells are edibles.
Yeah. Always high.
Oh shit. Okay. So you guys wrap up your short rest here in Variety, the Changeling Stronghold. You feel a bit reinvigorated after your many battles with demons already here in the City of Stars, which you got into it proper. You kind of wrangle up the Wind Dukes, the two Wind Dukes that have been captured here, ready to bounce. And Zed kind of comes up to you guys and he goes, yeah, was there any components that, the Mind Flayer had?
Yeah, a couple. What do you, we had to pay for them. You guys, compensate.
Who had them?
Not me.
Me, right?
I hope so. I hope it wasn't me.
I have just left it.
Is it in your inventory, it's magical, isn't it?
I thought I had the things. Oh, they are magical, I'm assuming.
The tuning fork is the.
Well, yeah, the tuning fork, but the note is definitely not on.
Yeah, the note wouldn't be. I don't know. I thought Soren had them too.
Okay.
Right. I'm just.
In my mind, he went up to Soren to get these things.
In my other possessions, I have tuning fork and sigil stone. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Got them.
I was just making sure because fucking I just went through and deleted everything. I knew.
Oh, boy.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah. That makes it easy, right? You complain to the Lord. Oh shit! What happened?
I whip out the fork and the paper.
He goes, "All right, how much do I owe you for that? A couple hundred gold."
I like look around. I'm like, "Wasn't it like 500 or something?"
I believe it was 800.
Yeah, I was like, "That's I didn't do the negotiation, you know." But
in
like,
battle, apart from as me. Didn't we just take our money back?
Yes, we GTA'd it. Yeah, okay, we gave him the money and then killed him and then got the money back. Yeah,
it was
500?
500.
It was 800. Aha, ha.
Wing. I look at
2,000.
Trying to scam these people. I say 500. He is misremembering.
No, I remember it clear as day.
I look at him and I'm like, all right, looks like it's 500 to 800, depending on who you ask.
500 to 800, depending on class. Okay. All right, then. Well, I'm going to give you the 500, unless there's, you know, you got any other information for me?
I'm like,
the amount of danger we went through to get this would be, you know, adding to the feed. I'm just kidding.
We're in danger.
That was straight up Ralph Wiggum. I'm in danger.
I'm in danger. I'm learning.
I'm like, oh, yeah, Amethyst, he had the stuff. Yeah, and then we went through a whole situation. It's a sigil stone that we got here and a tuning fork. It's in the plane of the abyss, I think, or something like that. And there's a guy guarding it. I whip out the paper. I'm like, is this a lot of information? There's an undead gatekeeper.
Yeah, he's a champion of Orcus.
It is in Thanatos.
Correct.
Ooh. Yeah, Thanatos.
All right. Okay, that is additional information. Give me a persuasion check with advantage, Soren.
Oh, okay. I'm good at this. 25.
He goes, all right. Well, with that information, that's more than we thought we were going to get. So, all right. And he kind of whips out a bag of gold and he gives it to you. You don't know how much is in it. He doesn't say, but it's an additional to the 500.
Okay. I'm just like, cool. Thanks, Broham. And then I'm like, oh, hey, what's the next step? How are you going to get this piece or the next piece? Like, what's the plan?
He goes, well, we're going to have to reconvene together, the Wind Dukes and I. And considering this part is in the Plane of Abyss, and you said it's in a mausoleum guarded by a champion of Orcus?
Yeah.
Yeah, his name's Zahir.
Oh, Zahir. Okay. Well, that is definitely a tall order to ask, so we're going to have to enlist some of the elite Wind Dukes members. But once we get together, we're going to be using the tuning fork going on over.
Right. Sounds like,
I mean, you're going to.
Oh, yes.
All right.
Don't die.
I mean, he's definitely gonna.
No.
You got captured by a fairly weak devil, not on the level of a champion of Orcus in, you know, Thanatos, you know, a plane of the abyss.
I think my headbutt almost killed that guy.
We didn't get captured by a devil. We were at a talent show performing for your crewmate here, and he points towards Dala, and he goes, and we were ambushed during that. There was no way we could have seen. We were not prepared for battle like we would be going to Thanatos.
Correct. Sounds like you're but you were knocked unconscious by beings not anywhere near as powerful as what we're talking about.
A giant knocked a floating island out of the sky, and we tumbled to the ground.
Sucks to suck. Uh-huh.
I mean, you can fly.
Most people died from that.
Okay, this is besides the point. More importantly, if you need our helps or anything, you just let us know. All right, we're always down for more work. Pays well. You guys.
Oh, you all want to go to Thanatos?
Nah, not particularly, but
I mean, no. Are you talking big game? You want to come?
Point at him.
You talking to me?
Up front.
Are you talking to me?
I'm talking to all of you.
I've been nothing but pleasant. I don't
describe this.
Especially this one. And he says towards Alexander.
I didn't say I would go. I just said that you're probably going
to
die.
I'm just saying you're talking a big game. You want to come?
I didn't say I would go. I would definitely die.
Now, hold on. I've got a great way to prove this. If you're tough enough for Thanatos, you can help us handle the giants, right? Like, it shouldn't be an issue.
Yeah, why don't you go on and step up into the octagon?
That's what I was gonna say. Only bird's tough enough.
Give me a persuasion check.
Okay. 22.
Bird's gonna die fighting for no reason.
He goes, all right, giants, huh? I mean, I could use some revenge, you know what I'm saying? And he cracks his knuckles a little bit, cracks his wings out, and you could just hear like all the tiny bones like crack throughout. And he goes, you know, I can use some revenge. Why not? Why not? We fight the giant, sure.
I'm gonna inside check this motherfucker.
Yeah,
I don't wanna fucking bristly is this fucking confidence.
Fuck.
I'll inside check him too, why not?
I rolled a 6.
Fucking Jesus Christ.
18.
7. Oh, 8, my bad.
Oh, wait, I have more than 18, right?
Bro, natural ass. No, 18. Bro.
So everybody rolled bad except for Soren? Yeah. Sounds like it, right?
I didn't roll.
Oh, you didn't roll?
Okay. Alexander rolled a natural one.
I did.
Oh, okay. So Alexander and Dala Brakka, you kind of, he's a little bit difficult to read. He seems very confident from what you can tell, but you're not sure how much that confidence is well-placed, really. He doesn't look like anything too special. Soren, as you kind of hear him talk and kind of get him riled up a little bit, you can see in his eyes there is like a lust for revenge and a very like a realistic look in his eyes. Like, yeah, he thinks that it can be accomplished. Like, he is not afraid to fight a giant or anything like that.
All right, I dap up with the bird, bro. I'm like, all right, bro, Ham, I think we're gonna head to the Devosh district. I would keep low, though. I heard there's like the giants are really good at throwing shit.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they threw a bunch of boulders in the sky and pour him. That was real rough. We got a first-hand experience. But the good thing is that we could fly, and I could punch the giant in its face. So I'm excited.
Yeah, for sure, bro, Ham. I'll look around, and I'll tell all the changeling bros, too, that if they need a place to stay because this place is getting overwhelmed and they got nowhere else to go, come to whatever it's called.
And you can see Casimir kind of comes over to you guys, having spent this last hour kind of contemplating what Alexander told him and the state of the city and overall the whole situation, the sit rep, if you will. The guy comes over to you, Soren, and he goes, I think I'm going to try to help a lot of the remaining changelings get out of here. There's a few of us, including myself, that have unfinished business in this city, and we'll head to the Devotion District with you, but the rest of them are going to abandon.
All right, I hang loose, and then I'm like ready to go. Can I
talk to, who is that?
Casimir.
Casimir? Said you would abandon the one thing you've gained in this city?
And what do you mean?
You were subjects, were you not? And now you own this place?
Well, like I said, I have unfinished business in the city, so I'm not going anywhere. But the rest of them, they have lives to live, and they want the best chance of living them.
Are we?
That's fair.
All right. So whenever you guys are ready to head to the Devotion District, you said, I'm ready to go.
Yeah, I'm going to roll out.
Okay.
That's cool.
So you guys make your way out of a variety in the Changeling Stronghold itself back towards... Are you guys going to go the direction you came when it comes to like getting back to the surface area?
If that seems like the safest, like unless we find another path that seems reasonable.
Can we go to... Hold up.
Hold up.
We went to the Thieves Guild beforehand using these sewers, right?
Yeah. I thought so.
Could we not go to the Thieves Guild? Because where is the Thieves Guild? The Thieves Guild's in the Devotion District.
No.
No.
It's underneath the temple of Cronus.
Yeah. It's underneath. Yeah. It's just not on the surface.
Yeah. I mean, it's.
Yeah. If you want to go back to where the Devotion District is, like underneath ground towards where the Thieves Guild is, you can do that.
Okay. We would avoid, I assume, the cacophony of shit upstairs. So, I mean, I'll suggest, I say we should pay a visit to the Thieves Guild. Also, it may be abandoned for plunder.
My only concern, though, is like, Ugo, he was like, hey, the Thieves Guild, everything went to shit, the boss left. What are the chances it's not just full of shit, like people everywhere?
Yeah, chances are it is because, I mean, you know, he said that the boss disappeared as soon as they kicked in the door. So, I mean, they know where the Thieves Guild's at.
Then maybe we should unclear out a section of this cult that is directly underneath your order.
I mean, my assumption is they blocked it off in some way, shape, or form.
Well, then your assumption being proven correct means that we are beneath the devotion district. Therefore, we go up.
If my assumption's correct, it's blocked. That's what I'm getting at.
I take out a piece of paper and I draw a diagram for Soren. And I point at the sewer going to... Actually, I whip out my map. I have a map.
Yes.
I point out the devotion district, and then a little bit before it, wherever we come out to get into the devotion district, we come out here. If they block beforehand, we are closer. We do not have to navigate up on the surface.
Yeah, I assume that was basically the path we were going to take anyway, right?
Like towards like if your original path, it wasn't like quite at the devotion district. You would have to like make a bit of an alternate path. But I mean, whatever you were planning, I mean, that's up to you guys.
Yeah, basically, that was my assumption, is that we were going to go through the sewer as far as we could towards the Thieves Guild.
Okay.
Which, yeah, I guess towards the devotion district, which is towards the Thieves Guild. Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah, it's not a complete backtrack, but it is up until we hit the sewers.
Okay.
Yeah.
So as you guys go back in that direction, do you guys want to do this stealthily or what's happening?
Yeah.
We have too many fucking people.
Oh, yeah, we do have a shit ton of people, but quietly as we can.
Okay, give me stealth checks.
Got disadvantage. Here we go.
Oh, I rolled boy. So horrible.
Natural okay. One. That's a 3.
11. Oh, I guess we should 14. All post it to make this easier.
33.
Jesus.
14.
You rolled 14.
I rolled pretty bad.
Okay, and then let me see.
Tight.
So 3, 11, 14, 33. And that was yours, Dala?
It is 18.
18, okay. So. Huh?
I am the knight.
What was your actual roll? Like your die roll?
19.
19.
Oh, 19. Okay, I was gonna say it had to be close to a 20, right? Okay. So as you guys are making your way back through the sewers itself, give me perception checks.
Disadvantage.
Fuck. 19.
Is it perception?
8.
Yeah, perception.
18.
I'm casting light on my crowbar and using it as a torch.
Okay.
13.
19. I can cast like dancing light around us, right?
Yeah, you can cast dancing lights around you guys, yeah. Okay, so we got 19, 19, 14, and 13, and then 8. Okay. Oof, my goodness, these natural ones. Okay, so we are going to have a little bit of housekeeping here to do for a second. So as you guys are coming down towards the sewers, you're probably about 10 minutes or so away from the Thieves Guild at this point, maybe less, from what your recollections are of traveling through the sewers and kind of getting towards that area. But you are in the sewers proper now, and kind of like in between you guys and kind of having to go around these different areas to get to where you need to go. There are like sewers and the water is all right there, acting as a kind of a barrier from getting from you going to place as quickly as possible. But you notice, Dala, Brakka, and Soren, something disturbing the water a bit. And you notice it at the very last second because two of these gigantic, or like they're not gigantic, but they're very large. Again, like these 10-foot, 11-foot demonic creatures with these sharp teeth and kind of like this fish-like appearance with these hooked claws come out and attack two of your allies before they could get notice of them. So I'm going to need, let me see, Atoq and Minoscus, or Atoq and Alexander, actually. Let me see here. Atoq. Does 17 hit?
Nope.
Oh, I have an event. Yeah, okay. And then Alexander. 17 as well.
Mm-hmm.
Does 17 hit on you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it does? Okay. All right. So let me see here.
Cutting words! Just kidding.
You can do that if you want.
Oh, shit.
You do notice this. The ones don't, though.
Yeah, I'm definitely using it then.
Okay.
Let's see.
You got all your bardic inspirations back.
Yeah. Oh, I fucking rolled a 1.
Good enough.
Okay, perfect. So yeah, you see this big, it has like these like pink purplish scales with these giant hooks and this long serpent-like tail from behind it. And two of them jump out and try to attack your teammates. You can see both of them just narrowly dodging at the last moment, but I need everybody to roll initiative.
Whip out my fucking knife.
That's not a knife.
This is a knife.
No, that's a knife.
I rolled a knife.
A knife.
I rolled the same initiative. Nice. I don't even need to change it.
22. Natural 20.
Meow.
What the fuck? I went Pokemon.
All my dice have been wrong.
He's got the monster deck.
He's got the
natural one. Sweet.
He's got the monster decks.
No monster decks.
He likes to flex his pecs.
He'll flex his pecs.
He'll pass all of his checks. His monster decks. Sorry.
Do 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 do. Wow, this thing is cool.
DMCA. All right.
DMC. What is this? What the hell?
It's DMC. Dante from Devil May Cry.
Devil
what the
May
fuck
Cry.
Is this?
I don't
asshole.
Know what is this?
Hook cord thing?
Let's see how this pronounced. Weastrolith, apparently.
Bless you.
Weastrolith.
Weastrolith.
I thought you said Weast.
What kind of compass you be looking at, boy?
Whose voice said Weastrolith?
Ryn?
Hmm?
He's talking about Madam.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know who it was. It wasn't Madame Marisha.
Okay, so an imposter. All right, he can't be trusted.
An imposter. Came out of the vent.
Among Us.
Ha ha. Ha ha.
That's Wastrelith.
I like Wastrelith. Weast.
Of course you do.
Yeah, pronunciation is always questionable there, Holden.
So, over Atoq and Alexander, right?
Yeah, I rolled a natural one on my initiative. Is it? Surprised the fuck out of me.
You're still surprised.
Yeah, so I would say like the walkway you guys are on is probably just about 10 foot wide. It's not very wide.
Oh shit.
Let me see here. And then these big fellas.
Did I just hear my doorbell?
Bing bong.
Like 10:50.
Bing bong.
Bing bong.
8:50. Mm-hmm. Go off. Mm-hmm.
Oos, okay.
Did you also roll the same initiative, Jeremy?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
Oops. I rolled a 9. Let me, do you want me to change that? I'll change it right now.
I got it. I think
I got it.
Okay, got it.
These things are kind
of. And then everybody else changed theirs already, right?
Yeah.
Correct the mundo.
Okay.
Live on Telemundo.
It's music's okay. Time.
At the top is one of the Wastrelits.
No.
Let's see. And it's going to try to hit Atoq.
I don't have inspiration anymore.
Yeah, I was going to take it off. All right. Let me see here.
Hit me, baby.
One more time.
Now.
You have some HP, I guess.
Oh, Wastrelith. Y'all kidding me?
Roll to 17.
Miss.
Okay, and then its other attack with its claws. Nope, rolled a 15.
Miss. I fucking dodged.
Yeah, and you can see, the claws are super sharp and the teeth are as well. Like, it looks like it's going to do damage if it hits you, but can't seem to find its mark just yet, Meniscus. So, let me give you guys. Go ahead. Sorry.
All right, I'm gonna run up over here. I'm gonna pommel horse over a talk.
Okay.
I'll do the split.
I fall over and I eat shit.
You can't go into the space of the creature though. I don't think, right?
You can't end your turn.
Yeah, you can't end your turn there.
I'm not in the space of the creature, am I?
Where are you at?
You are.
I'm right here.
You're literally
here?
Overlapping.
Can
the
you
creature.
Not see it?
No.
No, I don't see
it. It doesn't look like he's overlapping on mine either.
What the hell?
I don't see him either.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're like inside the dude. Yeah.
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 What?
What? I don't.
Yeah, on my screen, you're like inside.
They're large on our screen.
The two of them
screen.
Are under me on my screen.
Yeah. Same here.
What the hell?
Same for me.
Look at the stream.
Yeah, you can look at the stream for perspective. Come open my
door. Mine are
Tony freaking out.
Hey, let me try to refresh.
That's weird.
That'd be weird.
You can't enter an enemy space.
Okay, now mine's good again then.
So you gotta stack on top of a Todd.
I'm doing the split.
Oh, what the fuck?
Alright, I do a little like a curve. I use his head as a little pivot point to swing over here instead. Ow. And I'll reckless attack you.
Yeah, you can end in my turn. You can come into my space, but you have to leave the space.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to end your turn outside the space.
Yeah, it's only 10 feet wide, right? So he can't go up or down either.
He has to go.
But these assholes. Yeah,
he could go here.
Oh.
Right?
The water.
Wait. Because these are the walkways, right? These 10-foot spaces here. And then this is the little sewer river.
Yeah.
The other side is another walkway. Got it. I'll just attack from here for now.
Okay.
Reckless. I have a +9, so that's 16.
16 misses.
Oh. Second attack.
Oh.
That's 26.
That hits.
This is +6 only. 8 damage.
8 damage? Okay, very nice.
It's the lowest I rolled in a while.
Yeah.
I'll try to push it back.
Okay.
So just backwards to the right. Strength save. And I think it's a 14. 16.
16, you rolled a 17.
Damn. Okay, I don't push it back in. Atoq pushes me backwards.
Okay, and it's gonna
spin me up and knock you.
It'll make an attack of opportunity on you for leaving the space. Oh, actually,
with advantage.
Oh, actually, you are within its reach, so you do not take that.
Oh shit!
Oh, it's
has 10 feet reach.
With the pincers, brother.
Clamps.
The clamps.
The clamps.
Anything else?
No, that is all.
Okay, this is the bottom one, so it's going to take attack at you again, Alexander. Or try to. 13?
Miss.
Ooh, okay, that's 25.
That hits.
You take 19 slashing damage.
Uncanny dodge.
Okay, it's for 9. Total. One of the hooks does get you. He tries to bite you at first, but you manage to dodge out of the way, and another hook comes down and doesn't manage to slice you. And you can see the damage that he is dealing is no joke, from what you can tell. Soren.
Okay. I will slip in behind Yield and Alexander and stab the top one.
Okay.
So I'll swing at the same one Minoscus swung at. First attack is 26 to hit.
It hits.
For 13 slashing damage.
Okay.
Second attack is 21 to hit.
21 hits. 21
for 12 slashing damage.
Okay.
And then bonus action attack is 25 to hit.
Mm-hmm.
For 7 slashing.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah, so I just come in there, slice, and then I roll back.
I dodge every attack as it looks like he's attacking me as he's attacking them. I'm like,
And I'm like, Alex Broham behind me. And then I'll back up.
All right, perfect. Since you stay within range, no attack of opportunity. Sunny kind of looks frantically, seeing that Atoq is in the line of trouble. And he kind of, let me see, he'll fly up, and from above, he will, do a fire breath.
All time.
Mm. He thinks Atoq is fucking immune to flames.
Yes, they're of the same race, right?
I just burned myself in the last session.
Okay. So it takes a little bit of fire damage. You can see it does, manage to dodge most of it, but it does take a little bit of fire damage, and Sunny kind of retreats a bit back to where he was. Alexander.
This and Doodly Gage. Alright. I feel safe. So we're gonna huck a card at this one.
Okay.
The top one. A special card.
Ooh. Look. Look with your special eyes. Atoq
is being the tank for our fight.
25.
Right. 25 hits?
Ooh, I get the pick. We'll make it the shackle one, so he only gets one attack.
Nice. Okay.
And it does 23.
23 damage? Nice.
Does the shackle do anything else?
Half movement.
Okay.
All right. So he takes the damage. He is now shackled down. Anything else?
I'm checking just to make sure, but he might not get a reaction.
He already spent it this turn, but...
Did he?
No.
Yeah. Oh, no, he didn't. Yeah, he was
he
going.
Has reach, so he didn't attack me.
Yeah.
No, it still has its reaction.
Okay. All right, Dala Brakka.
I'm going to cast motherfucking Tasha's Hideous Laughter on the one below.
Ooh, okay.
Ha ha.
That's a wisdom save.
It is 16. I rub my hands together and I go, ha ha.
It rolled a 14.
Man's fucking donezo.
So you see this weird, like, aquatic demonic creature just immediately, like, falls over and starts holding its stomach in pure laughter, just, like, not being able to, like, process anything else, just having a fit on the ground, incapacitated.
I'm also going to cast Bardic Inspiration on Atoq.
Atoq. All right.
Hold him up, big fella. You got this.
Elytro is going to Misty Step behind this guy.
Straight into the fray.
Yeah. Imagine if there was like seven more behind him and he just didn't know.
Yeah.
What was that druid's name?
Misty.
Our boy that got beat up. Oh man, poor guy.
He didn't get beat up. Already. He got ripped apart.
He died.
Yeah. Started with a J. I forgot what it was. But Elixir actually teleporting behind him and manages to miss both strikes on the creature. Just kind of not really penetrating its scales. Atoq, it is your turn.
Bonus action, I'm going to whip out some manacles. I'm going to attempt to manacle this creature's claws together. I want to try and hook the claws into each other and then manacle the arms.
Okay. okay. Give me an athletics check.
Don't manacles only work on incapacitated enemies?
Don't they only work on beings with limbs that are not like one fucking thickness the whole way?
He's just gonna get out of them easily.
Athletics?
Yeah.
19.
Huh?
19.
19? Okay. So, it rolled an 18. So as you go to put the manacles on it, you like go to slice with one of its hooks, and you manage to like use that against him and like grab with all your might. It's a hook, and you kind of like put one of the manacles on and to tear another one. It looks very strong. You don't know how long this is gonna keep hold of it, but I mean, you got the manacles on it.
All right, tight. And I'm gonna say, solar blade. I'm gonna stab it.
Okay. As
it's manacled. For like 20 something, 22.
Okay, 22 damage. Nice.
Okay. Voice.
Oh, that was the hit?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, my bad.
I'm going to be doing more than 20 damage. 10, gosh. 15, 20, 26 damage.
Nice.
He wasn't lying this time.
Yeah.
All right. Hold on, but imagine you put those manacles on my ankles. Except I don't have
they feet. Make ankle bracelets.
Except I don't have feet. Don't they just slide off?
I'm not putting it on its feet. I'm putting it on its hands.
Look, it doesn't have hands. It has hooks for hands.
It does have hooks for hands.
Enhance.
It has hooks for hands. They
I'm not arguing with you.
I guess you'll deter him a little, but it's just like, it's out. It's just rattling
It
off.
Just like does this, like it's getting a manicure and they fall off.
Exactly.
That's what happens.
So
that's my turn.
Okay, so it is the the wasteland that you just a manacled up's turn. Okay. He does manage to kind of like unhook and like scrape across the manacles to get out, but it did take one of his attacks to do so. So
well, he only has one attack.
He only has one.
Oh, okay, then yeah, it's his turn. So there you go. Meniscus, it's your turn.
For the one affected by Tasha's hideous laughter, mm-hmm. do I get advantage on their attack? Like, I forgot what the affliction is.
I believe it falls prone, so I think you do get advantage on the attack. Yeah.
But we've been swinging on this other one, huh? Don't worry. Atoq, thanks for taking the hits. I'll step up in really quickly and reckless attack.
Okay.
On the top one, sorry.
He pushes me with one arm.
Get away really quickly.
I haven't been hit.
Stupid shackles on the floor for no
20, reason. 23 to hit.
23 hits?
For 19 damage.
Okay.
Second attack. That's a 27 to hit for 16 attack.
16?
Yeah, and then okay. I have nowhere to push him. Do I have to push the one I attack with hammering points? Let me see.
You're gonna squish poor Elixir.
We'll just squish him. Fucking push him from both sides. No, I can't do anything for bonus action, so I'll move back and let Ataka handle it.
Okay. This other one under Tasha's hideous laughter is gonna try to repeat its saving throw at the end of its turn. It needs a 16, right?
Jeremy.
Dala Brakka.
Yeah, 16, sorry.
16? Okay, it rolled at 16 exactly.
Son of a bitch.
But that is the end of its turn, so. Sora.
Okay, it didn't stand up, right?
No.
Okay, I'll move in. The one on the top with the manacle situation with the manicure, is he looking fucked up at all?
The one up top? Yeah, he's looking pretty fucked up.
All right, I'll just swing at him. First attack is 26 to hit.
26 hits?
I'm going to try to chop his hands off. 9 slashing.
Okay.
Second attack is a 16 to hit.
16 misses.
And bonus action attack is 23 to hit.
Hits.
For 7 slashing.
7 slashing, very nice. Okay. Let me see if Sonny gets his thing back.
Get him, Sonny.
He does not, so he kind of waits. Alexander.
Alrighty. I'll take a step forward, and well, that guy's shackles is worn off.
Okay.
And boy, I'm out of those, so I will. Just chuck a normal card at we'll do the top guy again.
Okay.
Twenty-five
hits.
For 17 damage.
That finishes them off.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I cut off his freaking stupid hook hands.
falls back into the sewer.
All on my turn.
Okay. Dala Brakka.
Alright, I'm gonna pretty much do the same play. I'm gonna... Oh, fuck, I cannot, because I ran out of level 1 slots.
I could help.
Alright, well... I'm instead cast Vicious Mockery on it.
Okay. On this bottom one over here, wisdom saving throw. Fails.
What do you call a fish with no legs? A fish, stupid. Ha-ha.
No wonder it fails.
He has no legs, dude.
He has no chance.
Yeah, well, that's all I had. So that's why he gets fucked, right?
Mm-hmm. What was the damage?
Let me see. Three total.
Okay.
Let me see. Yeah, that's pretty much my turn. I'm cool with that.
Okay, and then we got Elixro here. There's both his attacks last time. Hits this time.
He has advantage too.
Okay, so call that the first attack. Yeah, these are the second two. So 20, okay. And that. Alright, Atoq.
I'm going to bring out a crowbar, and I'm going to bonus action steady aim by using the crowbar to distract with the claw, and I'm going to get advantage on my next attack. My movement's zero. I'm going to cast Solar Blade.
Okay.
So I'm going to maneuver the claw away, and then Solar Blade, blah, and then slash at it. Thank God I did that. Holy shit, one of them was a one. 25.
25? That hits? Hit. Yeah.
Where is my dude?
Steady aim with a crowbar.
Man, that's pretty good. It's 24 damage.
24 damage, nice. All right, anything else?
Nope, that's my turn. I have no movement.
All right, Minoscus.
All right. This time I'm a fucking pole vault over Atoq and then attack this one.
Pole vault? That's tight.
Yeah, with my axe.
With your axe?
Reckless, and that's a 26 to hit for 10 damage.
26 to hit for 10 damage, okay.
And then does 20 hit?
20 does hit, yes.
For 17 damage.
17 damage, very nice, okay. Anything else?
I don't think I want to push it in the sewer. It's almost done. So, nah, I'm good.
Okay. Oh, he's going to stand up. Let me see. And then where are you?
I forgot he's prone. Why
oh, yeah, I already had advantage.
Yeah.
Same?
I didn't realize it.
Okay, and then let's roll a D3, shall we?
Oh, no. Hanzo's greatest nemesis. Talk.
Perfect. Mm-hmm. Our tank.
22 to hit on the disadvantage strike.
That hits.
All right. This is the first bite that hit, so you take 31.
I use uncanny dodge.
15.
So I take 15. Oh my god, that's a lot of damage. I just saw what you roll for that damage.
Yeah.
So 15.
Yeah.
Okay. Fuck. What was? I didn't even hear the attack roll. I just came myself.
Don't worry, don't worry.
Yeah, it was too high.
Yeah, it was pretty high. And then this next one's gonna be on Minoscus.
Which one?
Does he have an advantage or no?
Yes.
He does?
Yeah.
For 23?
Yep.
Okay. And you take 23 damage. Half to 11.
No, I'm not raging.
Oh, not raging? Okay, so yeah, 23.
Yeah. Jesus Christ. Oh, man, we're getting fucked.
Motherfuckers.
We're like, oh, man, we're fucking these guys up. Look, they got shackles on them and shit. As soon as they start attacking, they just fucking high roll everything.
I just imagine as these guys get eviscerated, I just duck. And, like, the claws are just, like, pinching the shit out of everybody. And I'm like, oh, God.
He bites me, and I bite him back a little bit.
I stand up, and I'm like, bros, and I'm going to swing at him. Okay. Damage.
Sober.
28 to hit.
28 hits, yeah.
I almost got a 20. 12 slashing.
Okay.
Second attack is 21 to hit.
21 hits.
For another 11 slashing.
Okay.
Damn, he's still alive?
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck? Third attack. I thought he was close.
I don't like how he said, oh, yeah, I'm
not. 15 to hit?
Oh, yeah.
15?
Yeah.
Misses.
Okay. That'll be my turn.
All right. Yeah, I mean, he looks significantly injured for sure. You guys done a lot of damage, but he's like a big, hearty dude.
Yeah.
Let me see. But still does not recharge his breath, so Sonny's going to stay in the back. Alexander?
All righty then. Everybody's getting fucking destroyed. I don't have any fucking cards left, so this is all you're getting. 19.
19 hits?
That's some beast-ass sneak attack.
Some sick damage. That is a crazy sneak attack roll.
You rolled 11 three ones. Holy shit.
3d6, roll 3.
Yeah.
One chat.
That's classic. Okay. Anything else?
I've done my best, and that's all you guys can ask.
I want better.
That's my turn.
All right, Dala Brakka.
Let me see. Minoscus, you didn't take that. Like, you didn't take like super severe damage, right?
He did. I mean, like, I took the whole damage, but I'm still okay.
It ain't severe. Like, you ain't dying, right?
No, I'm not dying.
Just relative breathing.
Just heavily breathing.
Alrighty.
I'm fine.
I'm gonna cast blindness on this thing.
Blindness on it? Nice, okay. He's got me a con save, right?
Con 16.
It succeeds. It'll be a 23 to the con save, actually.
Well, I still gotta say the fucking joke. What do you call a fish with no eyes? Well,
God damn it.
These are good jokes for failing.
Yeah, that's why.
Very good. Very good. Failed.
Perfect.
What else we got here? Shoot. I'm gonna cast Bardic Inspiration on good old Minoscus as well.
Okay.
Alright.
I hope you do better than my jokes, big fella.
I like your joke.
Alright.
I'm lying.
Hey, insight check on that.
I feel like he likes it.
Roll my deception. Oh god. It's 4.
18. You son of a bitch!
I really meant it. I'm looking for any help.
Nope.
Elixro is up now. He's gonna try to swing.
Please, Elixro, save us.
Hit the first one, just barely. The second attack. Oh, barely hit both times. Okay. Here. And with the second attack, he's able to put this one away, I believe. Woo. Yes. So yeah, Elixro from behind manages to slice into it, the psychic energy kind of bringing off his sword again and slices through it, knocking it into the sewer water, and you guys are out of initiative.
Yes!
I feel great, bro, Hams. How you guys doing? You guys doing all right? Everything cool? Nobody got pinched?
Yes.
Like bleeding across the chest. The talk has like fucking half a limb missing.
I'm fine. Just a little bite.
Yeah, I mean, I'm chilling, feeling great. I will look around and try to make bearings of where we are / what the deal is with the sewers. Like if this is something that has been in this area or if it just showed up or what.
Okay, give me an investigation check.
I'll help him.
I'll help you. I'm just kidding.
We'll help each other.
Because I was curious about that too.
Okay.
Okay.
Investigation 21.
21. You can immediately see that like the water in this immediate vicinity, probably like within 30 feet of these corpses, is like corrupted and fouled. But besides that, it's mainly just regular dirty sewer water. From what you can tell.
Yeah, I'll refill.
Probably like 5 minutes away from the Thieves Guild.
Okay, I'm gonna fill. Oh boy, do I have something? I think I actually do. I'm gonna fill a couple of my empty embalming fluid vials with this ichor, and then I'll refill my dirty water in the sewer.
So you have like the foul water from these demons, and then regular sewer water too.
Yeah, that's my drinking water. But
okay.
All right. Well, with my investigation check of a 2, I'm like, seems like everything's great. And then I'm I'm gonna put my weapon away and make sure everybody looks cool, and then start marching towards the Thieves Guild.
Okay. So yeah, you guys begin to march towards the Thieves Guild itself in the sewer. You come upon the hallucinatory kind of wall that is used to primarily, you know, just kind of hide this type of headquarters from people traversing the sewers or the outside world? Do you just want to go straight past it, or what do you want to do on the at this wall?
I think our plan is to boogie out of the sewers before the Thieves okay. Guild, right? So that we can go up to the Devotion District.
Yeah, you guys can do that too, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's the plan.
All right. So you guys managed to kind of bypass the Thieves Guild, go towards the one of the manholes of the sewer entrance to get back to the surface city of the City of Stars, and you managed to do so. As you come out, give me perception checks.
Oh my god. I rolled a 3, so a 1?
A 15.
14.
Disadvantage?
Why do you have disadvantage? No.
20.
Okay. And then Dala Brakka.
Let's see. Oh. 9.
Okay. So Minoscus, Dala, you guys kind of come out, and you still hear sounds of battle, and there's definitely like explosions in the distance and all kinds of other stuff that has been going on. I believe Alexander, Soren, and Atoq, you guys kind of all take a survey of exactly where you are in relation to where the Devotion District is. You're pretty close to it, just a few minutes, a few blocks away is where the Devotion District usually begins and kind of encompasses the space. You don't see anything immediately in the vicinity, but I mean, you could feel like large, like you can feel pretty much giant steps walking around, and you can still hear different signs of battle in the distance. What do you all want to do?
Is it towards the Devotion District, this noise of fighting, or somewhere else?
It's in a lot of places. Like, there's definitely towards the Devotion District, but it's in other places too.
All right. Well, if we don't see anything in the way of it, I would say we can go. We should head towards it as fast and sneaky as possible.
Okay. You guys gonna down for that?
Yeah. After?
If you are, give me stealth checks.
I'll cast guidance on myself.
Yeah, same.
Mother, protect me from their gaze.
Wodan is also not invisible anymore.
16.
That's what you think. Hey!
I rolled a natural 1.
Mamma mia.
I rolled a natural 1, but it is a 12.
I got 11. Why are you rogue so bad?
Throw your dice in some holy water.
All of them are wrong. Well, I have an odd one out. Let me roll this one for now.
22.
So what are we rolling for again?
Stealth.
Perception. Stealth. Or stealth. Sorry, stealth. Yeah.
The first one was for perception, you said, right?
Already rolled that one.
You had rolled for that. Stealth now.
Let's see. 9. Again.
Sean. Okay. So as you guys begin to make your way towards the Devotion District, you begin to sneak along. And as you get within the first few blocks, you immediately notice that the Devotion District is somewhat different. You can see pretty much from the border that you guys are about to enter in to as far as you can see is encompassing like a very grand temple that just seems to be like brimming with arcane energy. You don't even need like a detect magic or anything like that. Like Minoscus, your wild magic sensors like going off. You can immediately feel how much divine energy is just brimming from this temple itself. And it seems to be made up almost entirely of magic. And you can see there's like a different outpost on it, because it is like it's like a two-story temple, and there's like barracks that are probably some layer within the temple itself. But you can see that there's like outposts where there's like turrets and catapults and stuff that kind of fending off some of the giants and some of the other like flying creatures that are coming towards this magic temple. But what catches your guys' eyes the most is a huge frost giant that seems to be like just pounding with this giant axe on this temple itself. And it's kind of beating it back with this magic arcane barrier that is using to defend some of the temple structures itself. But as you sneak up on this scene, this giant, you notice, has a bunch of other giant heads like plastered to its shoulders and like some like from its hip. And as it's just pounding on the arcane barrier of the temple itself, all of the rest of the heads turn towards you all and immediately begin to open their mouth, and you can see just a coalescence of arcane and cold energy beginning to form. And I think that's what we're going to call the episode this week.
Not again!
The wrong element. It's the wrong element.
I hold Wodan in front of me.
I will never forgive your ass for this fucked up, repugnant shit.
Wait, so the heads were just a bunch of other giant heads on its head?
Yeah, I'll give you a picture right now. Give me 1 second.
I think I know what this is, too.
We know what one of these, haven't we?
I just heard the spell, and I thought it was just the council for some reason. Going to cold on hot.
All like, the councils are their spirits.
Yeah, I was like, they already lost? What?
Bro, they've got a magic golden pyramid temple. Like, they're fine. This is fine.
Why the fuck could they roll better, Honzo?
They got a frost giant with a shit ton of heads.
That wasn't my fault.
My role was like the same as yours.
Oh, okay.
It was voting.
You didn't help.
No, yeah. What did you say, Jeremy?
I'm sorry?
Did you say something to me?
No, did I?
I know who this, I know who this is. I know who this is.
Oh, is it a specific frost giant?
No, yeah. But I know where it's from.
Oh.
It is a specific frost giant, though.
Is it?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
It's probably from the giant book. Whatever it was.
The giant book of
those heads can actually move or have moved, I guess, once we
see. Yeah, them. They moved and looked at you guys.
Oh, the head at the bottom
polar bear cub
can like move as well then?
Yeah, all all the heads besides the main head is the one that looked over at you guys. Gross.
So if the giant farts, it's the first one to smell it, is what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
Fucked up, dude.
I like how that was your like the most pressing matter to you. You're like,
yeah, what's the etymology in regards to when it farts? Yeah.
It's important. What
does it do?
This thing looks hella fucked up. This image of this fucking giant.
Yeah.
Fuck that giant, dude.
But let's try not to die.
Pulling the card.
He rolled on perception a 21, which was your guys' highest stealth roll.
Jesus.
Whoa, can I before we go on a break, can we draw cards from the
No.
Let's see how many cards I can draw at once.
I'll do it right now. Shit, I'll do it with you.
We need magical barriers.
Let's do it. Let me go first, just in case it's a bad one.
Hey, is that breath a spell?
I mean, kind of.
Oh, counterspell. Boy. Good thing I have no slots left, dude.
Counterspell. Oh, I'm just kidding. Anyway, thanks for coming through chat room. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks. We got the big raid from Nick. That was very nice of him. I will send you guys some way, somewhere, somehow. Neither of you are going to stream right now, right? None of you guys?
Immediately. Anyway. I mean, not this minute. I'll probably stream it tonight, but not this minute, though. All
right. I can send them over to Steve. Seems like Steve's streaming.
Yeah.
Let's go. Upgraded Tasty Steve.
Have a lovely evening there, chat room. I'll run a quick 60 and send you guys over to Stevie Boy.